Ebel, Bella, Saint-Marie.
Good morning, blessed people. Welcome to Royal Morning News, coming to you from Royal FM 88.4, a lead story. U.S. Embassy in Cameroon has called on authorities to ensure security in one subdivision, as MP says the situation is far beyond farmer grazing problem.
I don't really want to think that's much of farmer grazers issue, because we have lived with the Fulani people for years. I was born there when the Fulanis were there.
Stay tuned for this and more in this edition of our newscast. Good morning once again. My name is Abel Bela Samar. We will open our news. Like I said in our lead story, the U.S. Embassy has weighed into the communal violence, called for an immediate cessation of violence, which has reportedly led to several deaths and the looting and burning of houses, markets and churches in at least 5 villages. In a press statement issued on Wednesday, March the 2021, the U.S. Embassy in Yaoundé, Cameroon, called on authorities to tackle all possible steps to ensure security of Ngwa, significant number of whom the population have reportedly been displaced and are now in need of humanitarian assistance. Earlier this week, in a media outing, the Member of Parliament for Ngwa constituency, Honorable Adamu Edwards Lambert, explained the root cause of the problem.
With the current situation going on, cross-section of the Fulani people cross over from Nigeria, and it is also said that some of them came from Banyo, Adamawa region. So they moved into this area, and everybody they met, either you were gone down, and women and children ran into the bushes. Some have crossed over to Nigeria. I think it's well organized. From Nigeria and from Banyu, they moved in. I must say that this part of the country is very porous. Ntong, Tim, these are villages that are closest to Nigeria, our last villages into Nigeria. And these are the villages that were attacked. I don't really want to think that's much of farmer grazers issue, because we have lived with the Fulani people for years. I was born there when the Fulanis were there, and they have lived all through. They are our brothers, they are our sisters. But if you see the current events that are happening, it's far from what used to happen.
Honorable Adamu further explained that these attackers carry armed.
Like the one that happened in Tong, at 4 a.m. these guys came in, started burning houses. Anybody that stepped out and was within their reach, they shot at. And, you know, the villagers are helpless. All they can do is to run. So there's no direct face-to-face confrontation. The villagers are empty-handed. They are not armed. Remember at the beginning of the crisis, it was said everybody that had an arm took it to the DO's office. Even cutlasses they don't have. So they can't even fight back. How will you fight back when somebody has a gun? Sophisticated gun, and you are there with a knife or with a cutlass. So the majority of them run into the bushes. So it's an attack, not like a confrontation. If they were Fulanis, for example, went for the Amber Boys or for the separatists, it would have been okay that they fight and get their ways out. But they went for the natives. That's where we feel bad.
As we out, he suggests the following.
I have a group of think tanks who tried to reason together, and we thought that it was time for all the sons and daughters of Ngwa subdivision. Sons and daughters here includes the Fulanis and the natives, that we all have to sit on the table and look eyeball to eyeball and say, where did we go wrong? What do we need to do for peace to return to our area? We have planned that for the 19th and 20th of March. We pray that it goes successfully, and why not? We will go back to the early days where we live as brothers and sisters, and we're trying to discourage the idea of leaving our borders porous. Like I said, they've given us some assurance that a military detachment will be sent to the northern part of Yamba to check the porous borders. I think that we will be sure that life will go on very well in our subdivision.
And we stay in a security-related news to say officials of the Ministry of Defense have been drilled on the concept of budget programming in line with the 2021 finance law and government's national development strategy for 2020-2030. The minister delegated at the presidency in charge of defense, Jose Betty Asomo, has challenged them to make concrete suggestions which will help ameliorate the ministry's contribution in development. Take a listen to the minister speak.
The conduct of public national defense policies is globally oriented towards the achievement of the main objectives set by the government of the Republic. Vision 2035, which entails making Cameroon an emerging country, democratic and united in its diversity. The action of our ministry aims at achieving the strategic objective of the Minister of Defense, which is to defend territorial integrity and maintain peace and security, which are necessary for economic and social development. This action will materialize through the implementation of a number of budgetary programs, which are strengthening territorial defense, participation in the protection of people and property, contributing to national development efforts, governance and institutional support in the defense sub-sector.
Minister Joseph Viti Asomo speaking. You are listening to Royal Morning News, coming to you from Royal FM 88.4. To our news of the day, the National Assembly will, as from today, pay tribute to women's leadership by organizing an exhibition at the Esplanade of the National Museum. The exhibition will run for a month and will feature a photo gallery comprising different women who have served in Parliament, portrait of women who have left the mark in the political life of Cameroon's Parliament, and the progress made in the promoting women's representation and participation in decision-making process in Parliament. The exhibitions fall within the framework of week-long activities organized across the country to mark the 36th edition of the International Women's Day. This information is contained in a press release signed by the Secretary General of the National Assembly, Gaston Komba. And in that light, that report, Suzanne Nayonge, looks at women and their culture in modern times.
Culture between kinsmen in Cameroon is gradually fading out with time. For some women in Yaoundé, for example, they describe their daily outfits.
I love wearing my gowns, trousers, because I feel relaxed in it. On a daily basis, I wear normal clothes, that is, the normal trousers and tops.
I mostly wear gowns, skirts, and tops on a daily basis.
I like being elegant. I like dressing in a responsible manner.
There are times I like to wear my traditional dress, but I cannot be going to my important place and I'm dressing in. I always like to wear these modern dresses.
Regarding their traditional regalia, here is what they have to say.
I wear it only when we have a cultural meeting in our village.
I usually wear it when there are occasions or when I'm going to church.
I don't have a traditional regalia, so
I don't frequently wear my traditional attire.
Some of these ladies say why they do not know much about their tradition and its effects.
The traditions and the rites and all that, I know nothing about it. And it's really bad because as time goes on, the future generation will even be worse.
My parents have not had time like to tell me about our culture, but
I really don't know much about our culture because I rarely go to the village.
For the few who have one or two imprints in their culture, their hopes are different.
I'm gladly going to pass on my mother tongue to my children, even only if I get married to somebody from my tribe. If I don't get married to somebody from my tribe, and
they will spend time with their grandparents. They must learn what I did not learn.
Mrs. Ngwenyi Victorine, our sociologist, explains why there is such a degradation.
We have to blame it on the change of roles. Women are behaving like men, some of them in cases of lesbians, or they want to take the place of men seeking for equality. That leads to a decrease in our cultural values. They pay close attention to what they learn in school rather than go to village meetings or to study some cultural values. The role of the social media too is very important, as the type of images and write-ups these young women read.
Here is what she proposes as way out.
We need to make a blend. For us to uphold our cultural values, at one point we must bring in modernism and tradition to see that the two go together. There is no way we can save one and we leave one.
All in all, this should be a period for women to also uphold their African values, for if they know where they are coming from, they will know where they are heading to.
Suzanne Nayonge in that report, and we'll take you out of the country to say at least 38 people have been killed in Miami on Wednesday in what the UN described as the bloodiest day since the coup that took place in a month ago. And it is with that note from out of the country that we wrap up this edition of our 6 a.m. newscast. Morning newscast with us at 8 a.m. in the French language, 12 noon Royal Midi, 2 p.m. Royal Afternoon Edition, 6 p.m. Royal Soir. The team keeping you company this morning is made up of Karopo Datsenso, who is our copyright clerk. Solomon Isana is our sound engineer. Link with our video editor on our Facebook page, Royal FM Cameroon. The news was produced by Suzanne Nayonge with editorial coaching coming from Jean-Pascal Santala. Coordination was done by our own station manager, Bertrand Nuruna. General supervision was ensured by Reverend Pastor Emmanuel Nobisai. For presentation, my name is Abel Bela Samari. Up next is Royal Matinal with Dominique Eleva, who is joining me in the studio this morning. Good morning to you, Dominique.
Bonjour, Ebel Bella Samari. Bonjour à Suzanne Nanyongue de la réalisation. Bonjour également aux nombreux auditeurs qui nous écoutent.
It is Thursday.
Oui, c'est le jeudi. Et aujourd'hui, on va parler de la réussite de femmes. Pourquoi est-ce que derrière les réussites de femmes, il y a toujours des suspicions? Elle a fait ci, elle a fait ça. Pourquoi est-ce que les réussites de femmes ne sont jamais perçues comme celles des hommes? On se dit toujours, elle est passée par des promotions. Je ne vais pas citer la fin du mot. De toutes les façons, pourquoi autour de la réussite de la femme, quelquefois il y a des suspicions. Voilà, des suspicions. Voilà. On en parle ce matin avec les auditeurs.
It is a quite interesting subject that listeners don't move a muscle because right ahead is Real Matina with Dominique Eleva.